Thanks a lot for having me, and I'm very happy to share my work always, because I love it, but because also this type of meetings permits me to sit down and to think about and to analyze more, something that I don't have so much the time to do in everyday stressful cultural job. So yeah, I will try to share some ideas. My English is not perfect, so if you have any doubts, any questions, don't hesitate yet to write in the chat, as Maya told, or just to interrupt me, it's no problem. It's better to be clear. To start, yes, I will try to explain through the different projects that we are working on why for us intuition is knowledge, and how we deal with this with young people and with teachers, how we work with students and teachers in order to use cinema in the classroom and to use cinema as an art, to transmit this art as a cultural object and a support to understand the world. So our collective is based in Sofia in Bulgaria, was founded in 2016 by my colleague, theater producer and director Dimitri Ruzunov and me. We were later joined by other artists and cultural workers from Bulgaria. And since then, we are organizing some cultural events such as festivals, educational forum, theater performances, aiming to help foster an artistic and cultural dynamic in the country with an European and international perspective. One of our key objectives is to develop forms of access to the arts for young, difficult to engage audiences, and thus to initiate projects related to the educational sector and to promote the art of culture and the role of art and culture as a political and social corrective. We are running two big programs, main programs, theater and science on one side and cinema in school on another. Some words about our philosophy, about how we think, how we conceive, let's say, this concept of cinema school. When I say school, school is the vector, let's say, the place where we organize together with the teachers, together with the pedagogical staff, the screenings, the workshops, the activities, but this type of activities could be done, of course, outside school, in libraries, in cultural centers for youth, in cinema halls. But let's say that in order to go and to promote a cinema and to give the chance to every child to have the opportunity and to see some different films. The idea is that school is the place where we can find the opportunity to work with different social and economical background. Let's say that in some schools in Bulgaria, for instance, there is no adequate heating in the winter. And that's a starting point, because sometimes when we argue about greater presence of art in school, we should, in Bulgaria, we always start from this. If there is no adequate heating in some places, should we continue to argue for this presence of cinema and other arts? And yes, so we as Arte Urbana and as a non-governmental organization, and I personally believe the answer to be yes. And that's why we are defending cinema as an art, because we think it has it as an important place in schools today for many different reasons, and I will talk about that in details, but let's start from the idea, as I told in the beginning, that transmitting the seventh art as a cultural object, as a support to understand the world, is our main idea. And for that reason, we are inspired and we are using an intuitive pedagogy or approach, which intends to be adapted to our era, marked by major and continuously change regarding the way of seeing, creating, producing, exchanging images. And these last are viewed on a variety of screens, from the biggest, those in cinema halls, which are closed now in many places, to the smallest, the smartphones, computers, tablets, etc. So this practice of producing, exchanging images is the first and most important in young people's life, also in many for many adults as well. So how we use that to how we transform that in a discourse when we speak and when we use images for speaking about cinema as an art, and how we make the difference between moving images as and film, and what is film, and how to bring it to the classroom, what kind of instruments are needed for this today in 21st century. Cinema is still young art whose death has been predicted many times, and it is very clear that this didn't happen, probably won't happen soon, we don't know, but we have to somehow show or be clear what is cinema to many of those who never been to cinema hall. There are whole generations in Bulgaria that never went to cinema just because there is no cinema hall in their villages or small town, and there is cinema hall most often in the mall, in the mall, in the big cities. So that's already reducing the chances to see some European films that we are aiming to show. I'm going to just briefly giving you a short context, but because I don't know how many of you know something about Bulgaria, but I think this is important to introduce, let's say, and the historical part. So in the 1927-8, there was a Bulgarian law for school and mobile cinematograph. And according to this law, schools and people showing films should aim to increase the knowledge of young learners and to increase the understanding of the population in the field of science and arts. And this is another great aspect of this law, and I was very surprised. So when a new school was planned to be built in a village or small town, it was obligatory that the school be provided with a cinema hall or white walls that could be used on screen to screen films. So from a present day perspective and point of view, it seems incredible that in the 20s, the last century, the Bulgarian Ministry of Education at that time held even the conference devoted to exploring the possibilities of using cinema in educating students about film in school settings. And at this time, it was also the first cinema school opened in a sport hall in a high school in Sofia. So here, a far cry from how things stand in 2019-2020. Cinema was integrated within the school curriculum with students discussing various topics related to films that they had seen projected during the school day. Afterwards, you know all that Bulgaria was under communist regime and cinema was largely used for the purposes of political propaganda, and many of the films that were shown were government approved, and Bulgarian Soviet film alongside some Western European cinema considered to have a left-wing orientation at that time. But we have to admit, it's very important to mention that in this time there was a very, very strong network of cinema halls, and it seems incredible this gap. But in the 1963, Bulgaria had more, as you can see on the screen, 3,500 cinema halls, and compared to 2018, there were only 69 with 226 screens, which is as I mentioned before, the reason that whole generation don't really know what is this experience to go in the cinema hall and to share the film with other people. So in the 80s, there were a state-led program, Bulgarian cinematography initiated a degree of film education activities in school, and a team of cinema critics selected approximately 1,000 films, creating two collections with short reviews and some materials about the selected films. And in the same time, the NATFA, the National Academy for Theatre and Film Arts, began a special program dedicated to educating cinema teachers to become exponents of cinema as an art form in the Bulgarian school system. After the fall of communism regime and the changes in Bulgaria's political system in the late 80s, however, mass immigration as well as the economic crisis led to a collapse in the educational sector in general. So hundreds of schools were closed, particularly in small towns and villages, and educational curricula have since been undergoing many changes, in my own, without a clear direction, especially in terms of artistic education. And that's why today these artistic subjects and disciplines at primary and secondary school have tended to be considered as non-essential and are often neglected in favor of others, especially science, literature, maths. So in this context, outside the governmental sector, however, there has emerged a series of projects and initiatives looking to address the lack of film education by means of local cinema clubs, online platforms, some free screenings of European films, followed by discussions with the younger audience. Nothing really structural, let's say, on political level. And yes, this was the reason that for us as a team was really urgent to go in this direction with through our work and to create some initiatives response to this lack, let's say. And so the first initiative that we started was the platform, the Festival Meetings of Young European Cinema, with the main aim to support the presence of high quality contemporary cinema in Bulgaria through screenings, masterclasses, workshops with film professional and other film education initiatives for young people. So during the past seven years, we developed a program for film education within the festival, with screenings and discussions. And what is very important, I think, we really started to create a space where children, young people could meet, create, express themselves, and really also experience not only theoretical part of cinema, but also practical. So they were involved in different ateliers, in different workshops, making teasers for the festival, short films, writing workshops, and also meeting, programming some films, meeting the directors, leading discussions, moderating. I think this this was a very important part through the years, but now it's getting much more important, especially today with the pandemic. We are pretty sure that this those type of activities are really important and relevant. So we are for the seventh edition that will be held in June, we are really aiming to go in this direction and to create, to concentrate mostly on the young audience. Now I will show you two teasers from the past years that I love most, which were entirely created imagined by some high school students. What they're showing also are a bit of our philosophy as well. Talking about intuition, for us it's not so important to do a film from the beginning to the end, but more to take some parts, take some motifs that are interesting, that are coming from young people, take them, talk about them, and this is also what we need to create space for self-expression, and then work with them and create, I would say, more practical exercises, because it's much more important. What is much more important is the process in which they are involved. Meetings of Young European Cinema, our festival, was the beginning of our activities in terms of film education. And afterwards, we had the opportunity to join CINET, European Cinema Education for Youth. It's a program co-funded by, supported by Creative Europe Media. And it was for us a very big chance. Not only because it's a great collection of films and also proposals for activities and pedagogical work, but also because it's a great experience to share our work with 10 partners from 8 countries, which are all involved in film education. So basically, CINET aims to facilitate the implementation of film education activities, and it's true that we are quite different countries in the project, from Spain, Germany, France, but also Bulgaria, Czech Republic. We have also some associate partners from Romania, Lithuania, and it's true that we are really understanding how the situation is different everywhere. And for some of these countries, Bulgaria included, we really needed some kind of we need this instrument, this possibility through which we can organize free public screening, both in schools and in other settings, such as libraries, cultural centers, and cinema halls. And I will show you now also the cine trailer, because I think it's giving pretty much the idea of what kind of collection of films and pedagogical resources it could offer.
aussi des voyages forment la jeunesse.
Now, the teaser is a bit outdated because this program started 5 years ago. Now we are in the sixth year, and there are new films that joined the collection. And yes, they're still not in this trailer, but it gives an idea, I think, of what this platform is proposing. As I told you, you can also register. I don't know if someone is interested, we can talk in the end, but it's absolutely free. And all the films have English subtitles, and also the pedagogical packages are translated in English. So it's a very good opportunity, I think, to use if you're interested in organizing screenings for young audience. So as I told you, for us it was a possibility to structure our programs and our, initiatives that we started, and also to be part of this bigger network, because it's important to be supported when you start something. So we did one of the main objectives that we have in CNET is doing as much as screenings as possible. It's easy to do screenings everywhere because the base is digital files. So we can, as you see here on the photos, we can do basically screenings everywhere. These photos, I like them very much because they're very clear, clear message about creativity when we want to show a film, when we choose a film, and when we want to show it, we can do invent basically everything. In this case, it was a colleague of mine that went in this village of Valenci, and with all the material and everything, and then he found out that there is no white wall, everything was covered with this wood. So here comes the creativity. He did this screen with white paper with the kids that were there. It was during summer vacation. And so they saw the film in this way, and it was a great discussion afterwards. And I like very much to show this testimony of some parts of the challenging parts, let's say, of film education in Bulgaria. We are very proud because we did over 350 screenings in nowadays more than 30 towns and villages, and we really try to encourage teachers, educators, cultural workers to try, and normally the feedback is very good because mostly because the pedagogical approach. And I have to say that each film in CNET collection has its own portfolio for teachers and for students, and this helps a lot, especially for teachers that are not very experienced. They feel pretty sure that reading this information and having us as tutors and team, it's probably the first step. It's easier in this way. That's how we convince them to start. The other part of CNET in Bulgaria are the trainings. It's also something completely new for the last years. Trainings for teachers, because to reach more children, we need more teachers, and we need to create, to raise awareness about the key objectives of a film education, why it is important, what are the what is the impact, and let's say talk about with them first of all, about film culture and the importance, because as we already told, it's not only films, it's all also the whole culture around and the whole system around, because there are many links with other arts, many links with also with their subjects, with literature, with languages, and it's important to encourage teachers to try, which is not always easy, but that's why these trainings are not something frozen. Let's say that we started in one way and then we're adapting and preparing different types. It's a constant process. So the trainings now are between 3 and 32 hours, depending on the type, depending on the group. And it's in constant, as I told you, in constant development, because we are integrating many new elements that we are learning in the process. For instance, this is these photos are from our last training we integrate some practice, and it's very interesting, even if in the beginning it's difficult for the teachers to try, but it's very important element that we are really we think that we're going to develop these practical workshops more in the future. Another part of CINET is creating access to culture. As I told you, there are many little towns and villages in Bulgaria where kids don't have access to arts or culture at all. So what is important for us, and what is it's really creating involving the network of what we call in Bulgaria Citalište. Citalište is a cultural community center for youth. Usually there are also libraries, and they have already a certain audience, let's say. So it's important for us to bring new opportunities there, because most of the time there are, for instance, folklore workshops or something very classical as guitar lessons, I don't know, which is good, of course. But here is the key point, is to convince, and again to bring the idea of transmitting cinema and the whole process related to this. Also, we managed to create some film clubs thanks to a program of, we found a program of Ministry of Education financing very symbolically, but still these film clubs, and we are inviting them. So they're working during the whole school year, and we're inviting them in the end in Sofia during a forum, Cinema in School, where the idea is to share our experience and to talk about it. This is about CINET. Another important project that we initiated with the Trust for Social Achievement in Bulgaria is Cinema for Development of Social and Emotional Skills. It's in a village called Dermanci, so it's still northwest Bulgaria. It's one of the poorest regions of Europe, not only Bulgaria. And the access to culture and art, it's a useless to say that it's extremely limited. And 90% of the students there are from a Roma community, which is a problem for one thing. They don't really, not everyone, but let's say 60%, the Bulgarian language is there, they're not their mother tongue. So sometimes it's quite difficult to, the first years of school are, could be really challenging, because they don't fully understand and don't fully use their potential because of the language. So the idea of this project was to work on these skills and on Bulgarian language through cinema. Not only Bulgarian language skills in general, and working on the full social and emotional development of young children through cinema. So the project happened in partnership with the school in the village of Dermanti. And here cinema is an instrument giving the ability for these pupils to express their thoughts, their feelings, to experience through words and images. And these skills help children to communicate with the world around them, to learn about elements of their own culture, to learn how to read one image, how to interpret it, how to analyze. And in this case, cinema was a very powerful tool for development of social and emotional skills and for attitudes that will make children, I think, more successful in the future, more successful also in the other school curricula. So developing social and emotional skills through cinema workshop for elementary school children was focused on developing children's ability to recognize, express, and manage their feelings, to recognize others' feelings, and to make meaningful connections with them. These skills reflect the success of cognitive process, such as decision-making, persistence in achieving goals, thinking of rules and norms, seeking support or cooperation, and in cinema is just that, cooperation and solidarity towards a common goal. You see a little bit of the project in brief, some important achievements, but I would say that the most important in this initiative is that we managed to create a motivation for studying, for education outside school, revealing curiosity, and really generating some ideas and some emotions that this kid never experienced basically before. So we created many workshops, also some short fiction and animation films. Quite a lot of adults also were involved in the whole process, the whole community, I would say. So the core activities were based on CNET pedagogy and CNET films and pedagogical activities. But we are, I think, most proud with the main goal that we were perceiving through the years. And this is the innovative class with the study of cinema. So in this village, Dermanti, this really small place, we have the first innovative cinema class for kids having now 11 years. And so it's a program that will be developed from this school year and for 4 years more. Again, it's a program that we develop with the main, let's say, the most devoted teacher in the school, cinema teacher, and also with the pedagogical staff, with the principal, because everyone is quite convinced that cinema is changing something in the life of these kids. And yes, we are continuing with the impact. We are trying to measure the impact of this innovating cinema class that started in September. So it is a good point to discuss, if you want, afterwards, if how we teach cinema in such a small place, and to talk about transmission and about possibilities that we create for children in social challenging, background. Now I will show you one video that is talking a bit about the project in Dermanti and also other initiatives that are already mentioned or I will talk about later.
Mm-hmm. направиш? Тръгвай.
Киното помага в класната стая за това учениците, които изпитват известни затруднения с класическата учебна система, да се изявят и да се себе изразят. Нещо, което бих казала липсва в нашата образователна система – себе изразяването. Деца, които много трудно участват, например, в часовете по литература или в други хуманитарно насочени предмети, изведнъж по време на дискусията участват страшно много, имат какво да кажат, конструират мисълта си, изразяват се добре.
Заниманията с кино трябва да са по-напоителни и затова избрахме да сме иновативно училище, за да може цяла година да работим по един конкретен киноплан, който да има определени цели, за да видим това по някакъв начин как се отрази на тяхното развитие и на представянето им в училище, на академичните им резултати. Защото ги мотивира ежеседмично какво ще се случи, какво ще снимаме, какво ще гледаме, какво ще дискутираме.
Много рядко подобни програми в България финансират, например, закупуване на техника, която пък е от ключово значение за провеждане на практически ателиета в дългосрочен план.
Киното е на първо място свобода. Те знаят, че могат да споделят своята гледна точка. И този продукт могат да го видят други, които да се вдъхновят. Затова е важно това.
Чрез филмите ние достигаме до децата, разбираме техните страхове, притеснения, радости, защото им дава една безопасна среда, в която те да могат да обсъдят въпроси, които не биха могли от дома или чувстват, че възрастните не ги разбират.
Не е толкова сложно да се прави кино в училище, че е мотивиращо, че кара децата да мечтаят.
В момента работим по финансирането на три проекта. Един от тях, Моето място в киното, има за цел да овласти младите момичета и жени, показвайки им филми, които са направени от жени режисьори.
И искаме да ги покажем в малки населени места в България, които са по-консервативни и по друг начин младите момичета не биха имали достъп до тях и не биха могли дори да си представят, че има възможност те самите да бъдат режисьори. Ще започнем с 5 училища в България и се надяваме да успеем да я разширим, като добавим още училища и още филми, подобни на тези.
Вторият проект, по който работим, киното 100 години младост, е програма на Френската национална филмотека и събира на едно място деца и възрастни, които са работили по една и съща тема през цялата година. Предизвикателство е да намерим финансиране за това учениците, които взимат участие в ателието, да посетят годишния фестивал на програмата в Париж.
Това наистина ги кара да мислят, че те могат и че те са способни. Затова именно работим с деца, които са от малки населени места в България. Те по друг начин не биха могли да се докоснат нито до френската култура, нито до тази международна среда на активно образование, иновативно образование. Това наистина е една инициатива, която променя техния живот. През 2021 година ще организираме поредното издание на кинофестивал, посветен на младите хора, като той ще включва различни работилници и семинари, насочени към тях. Търсим спонсори, които да ни помогнат да направим възможно най-много работилници, за да може самото събитие да бъде по-практически ориентирано и по-интересно за младите хора, които да се научат да разбират не само киноезика, ами да работят в екип, да разбират изкуството и да го използват така, че да изразяват себе си, своите емоции, своите мечти и всичко, което ги вълнува.
Аз искам още един филм да направя, но няма. На мен ми хареса, защото работиме в екипи и се разбираме. Да, това беше яко.
Това беше някак много забавно, интересно. И никак не ми беше трудно. Малко беше трудно. Мисля, не можеш да снимаш един самичък. И по принцип е по-хубаво да работиш в екип.
Elaborate a little bit more, you mentioned in your presentation that you could, on the CINED membership and how schools or organizations can become part of this big European initiative.
Yes, with pleasure. There are, let's say, the countries, the partners that are the countries that are involved directly, let's say, in the project, because there are some partners from these countries, as Bulgaria, Romania, Lithuania, and also there are some countries where there is no partner organization. But as I told you, for instance, everything is translated in English. So if one wants to organize a screening, he or she could register to the platform. And then we receive the main leader of the project, the Cinemateca Portuguesa in Portugal, receive the inscription and basically approve it. You have to write in few lines the project that you have for a film club or screenings. It has to be, as I told, non-commercial, but it's pretty easy, in fact, to register if you have already a plan or idea for a film education program. The pedagogical resources, if you want just to see, to read a bit about the film, it's without registration. You can go on the platform directly. I can send the link afterwards in the chat, and you can check the resources. Will Brexit affect access to Cine for us in the UK? Thank you for the question. I don't think so. So for the moment, we didn't really I don't think we have any restriction for the films. Normally, when we negotiate them, we negotiate for all European countries, and UK was already in the contracts for the films that we have in the collection. I'm not sure how it will be for the next two films that we are expecting this year, but for the collection as it is now, I don't think you have any restriction.
So how has COVID affected your activities?
Yes, this is the big question. So in April this year, we created a second platform, Cine at Home, where we negotiated some of the films, five films, to be screened at home. So children could, because now on let's say on CINET platform, we can register if you are adult or teacher or educator. But on this CINET at Home platform, we made everything possible for children and young people to register themselves and to have access to these five films in order to watch it at home. And then we were making Zoom discussions and also, we were giving some practical exercises to do individually, and then we were again discussing them on Zoom. So that was the probably from April to the end of June. Afterwards we came back in schools, because in September schools reopened and it was possible to do some activities, and we used this period, and it was great, because nothing is better than the real workshops and the real meetings and encounters and sharing films and activities with kids. So it was great, because we did quite a lot, in fact, screenings and atelier during this period. And then in November, everything was closed again in Bulgaria, mid-November. So we had again this period more on Zoom, but it's pretty difficult, I have to say, because teachers are very busy when they're online. They have many administrative work to do as well. And it was, quite challenging to organize on Zoom, but not impossible. And now we are back to school from the beginning of January. So we have to adapt, and nothing is clear. But for now, even today, we had an animation workshop in Kyustendil. It's in the south of Bulgaria. Yes, and it was possible to do it. So we are very happy.
Thank you. And you mentioned the sort of portfolio packages that go with every film that is part of the educational program.
Show, because I think it will be much more better to show the platform and the resources. So this is the platform. You can sign up here, and then to show you the package, for instance, for this film from Portugal, Aniquibobo, it's a classic from Manuel de Oliveira. And so here we have the pedagogical package. They're all written and done in the same with the same elements, let's say the same structure, in order to make them easy to use for everyone, and also to make a parcours, I don't know how to say in English. So if one teacher choose to work with three films, it's much more easy for him to prepare if he has the same structure of materials for the three of them. We have a small part dedicated to why we choose this film and why it's part of CINET collection, some technical specification, and the answer to your question, we try to be very visual, in fact, and the text to be in constant link with the images. So that was one of the main objectives for the authors of the booklets. We have a key photogram frame from the film with different themes that the film is asking the spectators or posing as problems, the stake in the films, a synopsis. Afterwards, we have a whole chapter dedicated to the context, to the author, to the career, and to the film in the context, the chosen film in the context of the work of this author, filmography. Also, we have affiliation. It's also partly as answers to your question, Maya. We have this type of affiliation and links between frames from different films. Also, outside CINET collection, because the idea is to open as much as possible the film culture and to create little by little this film culture with other films as well. We have also some testimonials from the director, different parts, some actors, but also very often different representative of the staff. But we have the analysis part, which is also quite important and rich with the different chapters of the films. Also, we chose to have the analysis of the film questions, the principal film questions, and also the analysis of on three levels. The first one is a frame, the second one a shot, and then a sequence. And so all the packages, as I told you, are constructed in this way. We have the part dedicated to the correspondence, and so the images related to other arts, photography, paintings, gravure, many different in the different packages. The correspondence and the connections are different. Also, the dialogue between films within the CINET collection. Also for the teachers to be easy to choose for the different age groups, and to make connections between the films, relations to the other arts, in this case literature, also photography, and also some crossed points of view. This is very interesting exercise for the grown-ups, more to read different critics, film critics, on the from different countries on the same film. And then we have the most interesting part for the teachers, which are the educational itineraries, what we do before the screening concretely, and also after the screening. It's very good, I think, because it's in the same time very concrete. We have pretty much analysis and very concrete questions. But what is good also is that every teacher is completely free to choose which part he wants to use and which part he would like to use more rather than another.
Amazing and so very well researched as well. is the main team based in Portugal? Did they do all the research and they compile all the packages?
No, what is great also about these packages is that each package is written by an author from the country. So each partner chooses basically the author, a film critic, also film professional, or could be also several persons working on the same film. And it's very interesting, I think, because it's coming from the country. So it's also, there are some, national parts that had to be discussed. And it's also cultural. So it's great that it's made with this from someone that knows not only the film but also the whole cinematography most of the time and the cultural context of the film.
Do you think that with the COVID situation, which obviously has affected different countries differently, and I know that in Bulgaria cinemas are now open even though with the limited 30% capacity, but do you think that perhaps the fact that cinema's becoming less accessible in lots of different ways might change fundamentally the way that we experience film, especially for the younger generation, after the end of the pandemic?
Definitely, I think so. And I see each time that I have the opportunity, it's not so often, unfortunately, to see it or to make a workshop and to meet those children and young people. And it's true that especially in small villages and towns, it's a very important regression, how to say, because during the pandemic, there is even less culture, even as access to art, because also school was closed in this village, for instance, in Dermanti, school was closed from March to September. So they only opened one month during the summer, which was great because we invested with many activities. But I definitely can see that it's a huge impact on them. And we have to use every opportunity to meet them, I think. So even in small groups, what we are doing now, for instance, in Kustendil, or even if sometimes online, unfortunately, it's not the same, but I think it's much more important to continue to propose different films because I think it's more relevant than ever, in fact, and this is more needed than ever.
Just talking about empowering young women, how are you moving forward with that project, and can you share any preliminary results so far?
Yes, it is a project that we started with the Bulgarian Fund for Women some months ago, and because of the pandemic we have we are a bit late with some parts, but we are very happy because the three films are already selected. So it's Jaleika, a Bulgarian film by Ralitsa Assenova that was awarded in Berlinale some years ago. The second one is The Other Side of Everything. It's a great documentary from Serbia for Mila Turalic. It's a very, really great. I must say, if you have the opportunity to see it, I really really consider it one of the best documentaries that I saw last year's. And the third one is a great classic from France, from Agnès Varda, Cléo from 5 to 7. So we saw, we managed to, thanks to Institut Français in Bulgaria, to have it in the this small collection. So the films are already chosen, and we are working now on the pedagogical resources that will be less important than the CNET one, but we are trying to make something more hybrid in order to reach teachers and young people, so to address them with these pedagogical resources. And we will start normally with the screenings and discussions in March.
I just wanted to thank you once again for your contribution today. You've been absolutely lovely.